Dear student, today we shall discuss another COPD, and that is known as bronchiectasis. So first of all, let us try to define bronchiectasis. So bronchiectasis is an abnormal condition of COPD which is characterized by permanent abnormal dilatation of bronchi and bronchiole due to inflammatory weakness or destruction in the bronchial wall. So let again try to understand. There is dilatation of bronchi and bronchiole, and it is due to progressive destruction or inflammatory weakness in the bronchial wall. So again, here is 2D. One, there is a dilatation. Kiska dilatation of bronchi and bronchiole. Kyun? Because of progressive destruction or inflammatory weakness in the bronchial wall. So this is collectively known as bronchiectasis. It is a definition is slightly similar to the emphysema. So in recall that in emphysema there was also dilatation and destruction, but here in the emphysema the dilatation was going to happen in the sinus, that is the distal part of the terminal bronchiole, and it is followed by the dilatation of the sinus. It is due to the destruction in the alveolar wall. So anatomically there is a difference that dilatation process of dilatation and destruction in the bronchiectasis occur in the bronchial part, whereas in case of emphysema this process of dilatation and destruction occurs in the distal part of the terminal bronchiole, that is in the sinus, which consists respiratory bronchiole, alveolar sac and alveoli. So this is the anatomical difference between emphysema and bronchiectasis. Clinically it is also very important. In case of bronchiectasis, the patient has got a very characteristic complaint that there is a production of cough with expectoration, and this expectoration is very much in copious amount, and it is also foul smelling. So foul smelling cough production is the very characteristic feature of bronchiectasis, that is very in large amount expectoration and sputum contain pus, and it is very much foul smelling. So this type of presenting feature is seen in case of bronchiectasis, which was not seen in other type of COPD. Just you recall that in chronic bronchitis cough with expectoration was the main complaint. In the emphysema, exertional dyspnea was the main complaint. In asthma, that acute onset of breathlessness was the main complaint. But here, in case of bronchiectasis, the sputum production, cough with expectoration along with the sputum, which is very in copious amount, and also it is foul smelling, that is the characteristic complaint and feature of bronchiectasis. So this is the clinical difference between all COPD major complaint. Now come to the etiopathogenesis. Sometimes this bronchiectasis is also associated with hemoptysis. So sometimes this type of complaint is also seen in the lung abscess, but you know that lung abscess is the a complication of bronchopneumonia, and that occurs in the distal part of the terminal bronchiole in the lung parenchyma. So lung parenchyma is mainly involved in the lung abscess, but here in case of, although the clinical presentation is same, but location etiopathogenesis is different. So these are the some similarity among the COPD and dissimilarity. Now come to the etiopathogenesis. So etiopathogenesis of bronchiectasis. So just try to see the definition. In definition, there was destruction of bronchial wall followed by the delication. This is the major phenomena that is going to happen in the bronchiectasis. So you must think that which is the most important factor, dilatation or destruction, दोनों में कौन सबसे important है. सबसे important destruction है, क्योंकि destruction जब तक नहीं होगा bronchial wall का, bronchial wall weaken नहीं होगा तब तक वो dilate नहीं करेगा. जब तक dilate नहीं करेगा तब तक हम लोग bronchiectasis नहीं कर सकते हैं. इसीलिए destruction is the major factor. So destruction is the initiating factor for the occurrence, for the onset of bronchiectasis. This destruction is mainly caused by या predisposed by endobronchial obstruction and it is followed by the infection. So first initial phenomena that initiate the occurrence or onset of bronchiectasis, that endobronchial obstruction. So this endobronchial obstruction is followed by the various kind of bacterial infection, and that infection initiate the inflammatory changes in the affected part, especially in the bronchi and bronchiole, and the inflammatory cell which releases a various kind of the proteolytic enzyme, and that causes destruction. Destruction of what? Destruction of the bronchial wall, and so that the bronchial wall become progressively weakened and weakened, and when the air passes through this weakened area from the bronchi or bronchiole, they progressively undergo dilatation. So that is dilatation along with the destruction that lead to the development of a disease of COPD that is known as bronchiectasis. So if you made a flow chart to understand the etiopathogenesis, the first initiating factor will be what? That will be endobronchial obstruction. It is followed by infection. For infection lead to the inflammation in the bronchi and bronchiole. Inflammation lead to the destruction. Destruction of the bronchial wall. Bronchial wall become progressively weakened, and when it is weakened and air passes through this area, it progressively dilated, and that may lead to the development of bronchiectasis. So this is the usual sequence, this is the usual step, this is the basic mechanism, this is the pathogenesis through which the bronchiectasis is going to develop. Again I repeat here, obstruction followed by infection, followed by the inflammation, followed by the destruction, followed by the progressive weakening of the bronchial wall, and then last result will be dilatation of affected part, especially bronchi and bronchiole, and that will lead to the development of bronchiectasis. So this is the usual step and pathogenesis or mechanism behind the development of bronchiectasis. Now you look in this flow chart that endobronchial obstruction is the main initiating factor. So any factor, any cause, any predisposing factor that lead to either directly or indirectly obstruction in the bronchi, that can initiate the progression of bronchiectasis. वो सारे कारण जो कि bronchi के अंदर obstruction कराएंगे, वो certainly will play role in the development of bronchiectasis. So let us see what are the factor, what are the causes of endobronchial obstruction. क्योंकि endobronchial obstruction ही main initiating factor है, तो बीमारी की शुरुआत यहीं से होती है. So let us try to understand what are the factors that lead to the bronchial obstruction that initiate the development of bronchiectasis. There are many factors, some of the congenital and genetic developmental factors that in case that lead to the maldevelopment of bronchi and bronchiole that undergo obstruction. So if there is a developmental defect, bronchi is not developed fully, the lumen is not competent, it is narrowed, that may lead to the obstruction. So there is sometimes ब्रोंकोइटिस में भी एसोसिएटेड विद द डेवलपमेंटल और जेनेटिक डिफेक्ट दैट ब्रोंकाई इज नॉट फुली डेवलप्ड द लुमेन रिमेन्स नैरो और माल डेवलप्ड. दिस इज द वन फैक्टर. द सेकेंड फैक्टर दैट मे बी एसोसिएटेड विद द जेनेटिक डिजॉर्डर दैट समटाइम ब्रोंकोइटिस इज एसोसिएटेड विद द सिस्टिक फाइब्रोसिस. सिस्टिक फाइब्रोसिस इज ए ऑटोसोमल रिसेसिव डिजॉर्डर एंड दैट इज एसोसिएटेड विद द हाइपर सिक्रीशन ऑफ द ऑल ग्लैंड इन द बॉडी. जो बॉडी में जितना भी ग्लैंड है दैट अंडर गो हाइपर सिक्रीशन. सो यू नो दैट फैक्ट दैट इन द ब्रोंकाई द म्यूकस लेयर कंटेन म्यूकस ग्लैंड सो दे बिकम मोर हाइपर सेक्रेटरी एंड दैट लीड टू द ओवर सिक्रीशन ऑफ द म्यूकस दैट एक्यूमुलेट इन द लुमेन ऑफ द ब्रोंकाई एंड ब्रोंकियोल एंड कॉजेज ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन. सो सिस्टिक फाइब्रोसिस इज इनडायरेक्टली एसोसिएटेड विथ ब्रोंकोएक्टेसिस. ऑल्दो देर आर अदर मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑल्सो इन केस ऑफ सिस्टिक फाइब्रोसिस बट वन ऑफ देम इज ब्रोंकोएक्टेसिस बिकॉज ऑफ ओवर सिक्रीशन ऑफ म्यूकस मटेरियल फ्रॉम द म्यूकस सिक्रेटिंग ग्लैंड प्रेजेंट इन द सब म्यूकस लेयर ऑफ द ब्रोंकाई एंड ब्रोंकियोल. Another factor that is known as that may sometimes it may be associated with the immunodeficient state. It's a congenital immunodeficient disorder may be associated with various kind of the infection of the bronchi and that initiate the inflammation, destruction and lead to the bronchiectasis. So this is another factor, immunodeficient stage that may be cause bronchiectasis. A very important disorder sometimes lead to the development of bronchiectasis that is known as immotile cilia syndrome. That is known as immotile cilia syndrome. In the other word, other term, it is also given a name that Carta-Grenner syndrome. इसका दूसरा नाम है Carta-Grenner syndrome. तो Carta-Grenner सिंड्रोम और इमोटाइल सीलिया सिंड्रोम में क्या होता है कि देयर इज ए डिफेक्ट इन द सीलियरी मूवमेंट. द माइक्रोटिब्यूल ऑफ द फिलामेंट ऑफ द सीलिया हैज नॉट फुल्ली डेवलप्ड और देयर इज ए जेनेटिक वीकनेस दैट इट इज इमोटाइल. द सीलिया रिमेन्स इमोटाइल. इट इज नॉट एक्टिव अगेंस्ट द फॉरेन बॉडी. सो the ciliary movement is going to impaired here and that lead to the development of accumulation of secretory material in the lumen of the bronchi and that causes blockage of obstruction and it is followed by the infection and that lead to the bronchiectasis. The mechanism step wahi chalu ho jayega kyunki jaise hi blockage hoga secretory material se it is followed by the infection and infection may lead to the development of bronchiectasis. So this is another this Carta-Grenner syndrome has got three features. Many questions sometimes ask in MCQ based examination. Carta-Grenner syndrome में तो एक bronchiectasis होगा ही. It is also associated with the sinusitis and situs inversus. So there are three components in the immotile cilia syndrome or Carta-Grenner syndrome. क्या क्या? First bronchiectasis, second sinusitis, थर्ड साइटस इनवर्सस. सो दीज आर द थ्री कंपोनेंट ऑफ Carta-Grenner सिंड्रोम एंड इट इज एसोसिएटेड विद ब्रोंकोएक्टेसिस. समटाइम Carta-Grenner सिंड्रोम इज ऑल्सो एसोसिएटेड विद द इनफर्टिलिटी इन द मेल एंड इट इज बिकॉज दैट द स्पर्म मोटिलिटी इज ऑल्सो गोइंग टू रिड्यूस और इम्पेयर्ड सो दैट लीड टू द इनफर्टिलिटी. सो दिस इज अनदर फैक्टर. समटाइम दिस ब्रोंकोएक्टेसिस इज caused by obstruction and that obstruction may be different kind, different type of obstruction in the bronchi may lead to the secondary cause. That was the all these causes were congenital or genetic causes but there are sometimes bronchi may be obstructed by the secondary cause. Or secondary cause may be either in the lumen of the bronchi or from the wall of the bronchi or from the outside of the bronchi. So tino jaga there are three main region where that may lead to the obstruction in the bronchi. Suppose if there is a lumen mein agar defect hai, lumen mein defect kya ho sakta hai, if there is a foreign body in impact, if there is a tumor or new growth in the lumen of the bronchi और इफ देयर इज ए इंडोट्रैकियल इंट्यूबेशन प्रोलॉन्ग इंडोट्रैकियल इंट्यूबेशन मै लीड टू द इन्फ्लामेशन और डिस्ट्रक्शन एंड मे इनिशिएट द ब्रोंकोएक्टेसिस और इफ देयर इज ए इन्फ्लामेशन इन द वॉल ऑफ द ब्रोंकाई दैट कॉजेज ए स्ट्रक्चर फॉर्मेशन और इवन स्कारिंग इन द ब्रोंकियल वॉल एंड दैट फाइब्रोसिस में लीड टू द नैरोइंग ऑफ द ब्रोंकाई एंड कॉजेज ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन इफ देयर इज ए कंप्रेशन फ्रॉम द आउटसाइड बाहर से अगर कंप्रेशन हो ब्रोंकाई के ऊपर आइदर ड्यू टू द ट्रॉमाटिक इंजुरी और ड्यू टू द एनी लंप इन द रीजन ऑफ ब्रोंकाई इट इज़ वेरी कॉमनली एसोसिएटेड विद द हिलार लिम्फ एडेनोपैथी व्हेन द लिम्फ नोड हिलार लिम्फ नोड इज गोइंग टू इनलार्ज इट कॉजेज कंप्रेशन ओवर द ब्रोंकाई एंड द ब्रोंकाई इज गोइंग टू ऑब्स्ट्रक्टेड एंड व्हेन देयर इज ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन द सेम फिनोमेना सेम स्टेप विल बी स्टार्टेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ इन्फेक्शन इन्फ्लामेशन डिस्ट्रक्शन एंड डाइलिटेशन एंड दैट लीड टू द ब्रोंकोएक्टेसिस सो एनी कॉज दैट lead to the obstruction in the bronchi either due to the foreign body or due to the inflammation or due to the trauma or due to the injury or due to the external compression by the enlarged lymph node or due to the any growth in the lumen of the bronchi so all these factors are associated with the directly or indirectly lead to the obstruction and when there is obstruction the same स्टेप विल बी स्टार्टेड ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन इज फॉलोड बाई इन्फेक्शन इन्फेक्शन इज फॉलोड बाई द इन्फ्लामेटरी रिएक्शन इज फॉलोड बाई डिस्ट्रक्टिव चेंजेज इन द वॉल एंड दैन देयर इज ए प्रोग्रेसिव वीकनेस एंड दैट एरिया प्रोग्रेसिवली अंडर गो डाइलिटेशन एक्सपेंशन एंड एक्सपेक्शन एंड दैट लीड टू द ब्रोंकोएक्टेसिस सो दीज आर द सम कॉजेज समटाइम obstruction followed by the infection is the major factor that play role in the development of bronchiectasis the bacterial usual bacteria that are lead to the infection like streptococcus staphylococcus is the main bacteria that lead to the infection because of any obstructive lesion in the bronchi sometimes bronchiectasis may occur as a complication of pulmonary tuberculosis or even necrotizing pneumonia. So pneumonia or tuberculosis भी कभी कभी bronchiectasis करा देता है So bronchiectasis occurs here as a secondary complication, of pulmonary tuberculosis and necrotizing pneumonia. So these are the some factors that are playing the role in the development of bronchiectasis. So you must know the mechanism as well as the factor that play role in the development of bronchiectasis meaning by again I told you the all those factors all those causes all those etiological factor that lead to directly or indirectly obstruction in the bronchi and bronchiole that certainly lead to the development of bronchiectasis it is because that obstruction is followed by various kind of bacterial infection like staphylococcus streptococcus these bacteria causes inflammatory reaction because of the some of the proteolytic enzymes are released and by the direct action of this bacteria may lead to the progressive destruction and weakening in the bronchial wall and the wall become more thin and that lead to the progressively dilated and when it is dilated that initiate or that lead to the development of a disease known as bronchiectasis. So I think the mechanism as well as the factors, how these factors play the role, you understand. Now come to the gross and microscopic changes. कहाँ पर होता है कैसे होता है So let us try to understand. No doubt the anatomically or the site where the bronchiectasis develop कौन सा जगह होगा respiratory system में the bronchi and bronchiole this is the major site where the dilatation and destruction is going to happen like emphysema जहाँ emphysema में कहाँ हो रहा था in case of a sinus but here the pathology or the initiation of the disease start in bronchi and bronchiole. Here the most important the site is lung lower lobe of the lung is going to involve in the form of diffuse or segmental pattern बाइलेटरल इन्वॉल्वमेंट भी हो सकता है, यूनिलैटरल भी होता है, बाइलेटरल भी हो सकता है, दोनों साइड में हो सकता है। और लोअर लोब ज़्यादा इन्वॉल्व होता है इन केस ऑफ ब्रोंकोएक्टेसिस, एंड इट इज हैज बीन सीन दैट द लेफ्ट लोअर लोब इज स्लाइटली मोर कॉमनली अफेक्टेड दैन द राइट लोअर लोब, लेफ्ट लोअर लोब बिकॉज इट इज मोर वर्टिकल, सो दैट मे लीड टू द ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन मोर कॉमनली इन दिस एरिया, एंड सो दैट दिस एरिया इज मोर कॉमनली अफेक्टेड दैन राइट साइड। दोनों लंग इन्वॉल्व हो सकता है, राइट भी हो सकता है, लेफ्ट भी हो सकता है, लेकिन लेफ्ट लोअर लोब ज़्यादा होता है बिकॉज ऑफ द एनाटोमिकल रिलेशन दैट इज इट इज मोर वर्टिकल। अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्ट, द साइज ऑफ द सेगमेंट डायलेटेड एरिया, द साइज ऑफ द डायलेटेड द ब्रोंकाई, द मेजर चेंजेज दैट ब्रोंकाई इज डायलेटेड, ग्रॉसली द ब्रोंकाई अफेक्टेड ब्रोंकाई इज डायलेटेड एक्सपेंडेड, सो इट हैज बीन सीन दैट टू सी ब्रोंकोएक्टेसिस द डायलेटेशन डायलेटेड एरिया डायमीटर शुड बी मोर देन 2 mm, सो मोर देन 2 mm साइज डायलेट हो जाता है। अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्ट दैट इन दिस ग्रॉसली द प्लूरा इज ऑल्सो इन्वॉल्व, एंड प्लूरा दैट जसन प्लूरा जहाँ पर ये प्रक्रिया हो रही है वहाँ का प्लूरा दैट बिकम मोर फाइब्रोटिक एंड मोर थिकन, सो प्लूरा बिकम मोर फाइब्रोटिक मोर थिकन। द शेप ऑफ द अफेक्टेड ब्रोंकाई, जो ब्रोंकाई अफेक्ट हुआ है, जो डायलेट हुआ है, वो वेरियस शेप का हो सकता है। द डायलेटेशन ऑफ ब्रोंकाई इज ऑफ वेरियस शेप लाइक सिलिंड्रिकल शेप, इन द फॉर्म ऑफ सर्कुलर शेप, इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ट्यूबुलर शेप, इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वैरिकोस शेप, बट इट हैज बीन सीन इन ब्रोंकोएक्टेसिस दैट सिलिंड्रिकल शेप इज स्लाइटली मोर कॉमन दैन अदर टाइप, तो सिलिंड्रिकली इट इज ए वेरी कॉमनली सिलिंड्रिकल शेप ऑफ डायलिटेशन इज सीन मोर कॉमनली, बट अदर टाइप में भी हैपेंड। सो दिस इज द साइट ऑफ द, दिस इज द शेप, दिस इज द साइज, तो साइट क्लियर हो गया कहाँ होता है, लेफ्ट लोअर लोब में साइज क्या होना चाहिए 2 mm से ज़्यादा होता है, शेप कैसा होता है सिलिंड्रिकल ज़्यादा होता है लेकिन और भी शेप हो सकता है, प्लूरा कैसा हो जाता है, प्लूरा जहाँ पर ये प्रक्रिया होता है वहाँ का प्लूरा मोर थिकन हो जाता है और मोर फाइब्रोटिक हो जाता है, और लंग भी अछूता नहीं रहता है उस एरिया का, उस जगह जहाँ पर एक प्रक्रिया हो रही है, लंग पैरेन्काइमा इज ऑल्सो गोइंग टू इन्वॉल्व इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लंग पैरेन्काइमा इज डिमिनिश्ड और डैमेज और इट इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय द फाइब्रोसिस। सो इन दिस वे ग्रॉसली वी कैन सी इफ़ यू कट सेक्शन, अगर हम लोग करें उस एरिया का लोअर लोब का, तो हम लोग पाते हैं कि देयर इज अ हॉनी कॉम्ब अपियरेंस ऑफ द लंग, इट इज द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन इज आस्क दैट हॉनी कॉम्ब अपियरेंस ऑफ द लंग इज सीन इन केस ऑफ ब्रोंकोएक्टेसिस। सो दिस आर द चेंजेस दैट कैन बी सीन बाय द नेकेड आई बाय ग्रॉस एग्जामिनेशन, एंड इफ यू गो फॉर द माइक्रोस्कोपिक एग्जामिनेशन यू विल बी फाइंड that there are very specific changes are seen in the different layer of the bronchi and bronchiole. The lumen is the first site. The lumen is filled with what? You can easily understand what the lumen. The lumen will filled with the mucus plug, the pus material, the exudative material. It is more viscous. So lumen is filled by this material. Since there is a bacterial infection, so there may be chance of pus, and if when it is come out in the form of expectoration or a sputum, it is very much foul smelling, and the production of this material is very heavy, so that large amount of the cough material expectoration or a sputum is going to produce, and very characteristically it is foul smelling because of the supervening of the bacterial infection. Pus is present here. Lumen ke baad epithelium aata hai, to bronchial epithelium undergo either it remains normal or it may be ulcerated, it may be damaged, there may be discontinuity of the lining epithelium, there may be also adaptative changes in the lining epithelium in the form of squamous metaplasia. So due to the chronic irritation by the exudative material, the epithelium undergo conversion into other type of epithelium in the form of squamous metaplasia, and that squamous metaplasia may lead to the development of bronchogenic carcinoma in the future. So this is the changes that can be seen in the epithelial layer. if you go proceed forward and go to the sub mucus and mucus layer, the mucus is layer is very much active and they are very much hypersecretory stage, and there is infiltration of large number of the inflammatory cell, especially neutrophil and lymphocytes. Chronic inflammatory cell as well as acute inflammatory cells are present in large number. There should be destruction in the bronchial wall, so bronchial wall has got destructive changes, and the destruction is followed by the healing process. So somewhere there will be fibrosis because of the healing of the destructed area. So destruction jahan par hoga wahan par healing bhi hota hai, healing kam hota hai, so that healing is identified by the fibrosis. So bronchial fibrosis will be seen. Another important change is that the lung, adjacent lung parenchyma is going to destroy or damage. It is replaced by the fibrosis, and sometimes the feature of interstitial pneumonia is seen in the affected area in the lung parenchyma. Interstitial pneumonia can be a feature of interstitial pneumonia can be seen. The pleura is, I have already told you that pleura bhi achhuta nahi rahata hai. Disease bronchitis se lekar ke lung parenchyma tak, aur lung parenchyma ke baad jo pleura, adjacent pleura hota hai, usko bhi involve kar leta hai. To pleura jo more adherent ho jata hai lung se aur bronchitis se, it become more adherent, more thickened and more fibrotic. So in the affected area the pleura become more fibrotic and more adherent between the lung parenchyma and pleura. So there is a formation of a fibrous band between the lung and pleura. So fibrotic band is going to form here, the pleura become more thickened. So in this way the pleura undergo somewhat changes. So you just see here that the changes are not limited only in the bronchi and bronchiole. The micro, as the disease progresses, because it is a irreversible condition, it is a permanent condition, so as the disease is going to progresses, it can involve first bronchi, bronchial wall, then followed by the lung parenchyma, and then it also involve the adjacent pleura. So all the segment of the respiratory system is going to involve here. So that is why the prognosis, since the destruction and dilatation is very much irreversible and it is a permanent, it is abnormal condition, abnormally dilated, and permanent changes are going to seen here. So that is why the prognosis of the bronchiectasis is very, very bad, because the destructive changes is going to progress. So that is why the disease may involve the various kind of the various component of the respiratory system, and that may lead to the aggravation of the disease. Another important, if the disease clinically, diagnosis of the bronchiectasis is done by the clinical feature as well as the sum of the microscopy, sum of the radiological feature. So clinical presentation is very, very important. It can occur in all age group, and the patient usually present with cough along with the production of heavy or copious amount of the expectoration and sputum, which is very much foul smelling. So this is the most important presenting feature of a patient suffering from bronchiectasis. The production is so heavy that generally the clinician ignore or clinically does not want to see the patient, because the smelling nature of the production of cough material. So patient generally clinician or physician hate to see the patient of bronchiectasis. It is so advanced condition. So this is the prognosis is very always bad. Only treatment is given, the supportive treatment here. Again, another feature that the complication is very important in case of bronchiectasis. So bronchiectasis is complicated in the form of hemoptysis is very commonly seen in the case of bronchiectasis. Infection is very important here. So infection, recurrent attack of infection is very commonly seen in case patient of bronchiectasis. So bronchiectasis ke mariz ko doctor jaldi take up nahi karna chahta hai, because it is so show bad presentation of the patient. So, but when the patient come to the clinic, to the clinician, because of the recurrent attack of infection and production of large amount of cough, so that may initiate, that may causes the patient to come to the doctor that he has got recurrent attack of infection, fever along with weight loss, weakness, all manifestation of infection is going to seen here, and the heavy amount of production of expectoration cough and sputum is the main complaint that causes a patient to go to the his clinician. So this is the main complaint and main thing is going to happen. If it is progressed for other long duration, there may be chance of clubbing, there may be chance of secondary amyloidosis, there may be chance of development of poor pulmonale. So these are the some important complications that can be seen in the patient of bronchiectasis. So bronchiectasis is a bad form of COPD. इसको हम लोग दूसरे शब्दों में कहें कि COPD का ये सबसे खराब रूप है bronchiectasis. जितना भी डिजीज है, chronic bronchitis, emphysema, ब्रोंकोलास्टोमा, ये सब तो क्यूरेबल भी है और प्रिवेंटेबल भी है, लेकिन ब्रोंकोएक्टेसिस से क्यूरेबल नहीं है, बिकॉज जो भी चेंजेज होता है वो परमानेंट होता है, इरिवर्सिबल होता है. इसीलिए इसमें प्रोग्नोसिस हमेशा ख़राब ही रहता है. पेशेंट में सफर विद द रिकरेंट अटैक ऑफ रेस्पिरेटरी इन्फेक्शन, हिमेप्टेसिस इज द वेरी डेंजरस कॉम्प्लिकेशन दैट मे क्रिएट द मेडिकल इमरजेंसी. सो poor pulmonale is another complaint. Breathlessness is sometimes going to seen here because of the blockage in the respiratory lumen. So breathlessness may be seen in the late stages. So these are the things. Only the patient is treated only by the conservative treatment by giving the proper antibiotic, bronchodilator, cough expectorant with mucolytic, auto inhalation it may be needed. If there is a hemoptysis, it requires another type of treatment. So these are the things, these are the facts about the bronchiectasis. I think the concept should be clear, but still if you have confusion in whole COPD, emphysema, bronchiectasis, bronchiolasthma, chronic bronchitis, because these four diseases are very commonly seen in the day-to-day practice. So if you have any confusion in this all for COPD, you can ask me, you can write a question on message. So these are the whole COPD. In the next class we shall start another disease of respiratory system, especially restrictive lung disease. Till thank you.